One of the most exciting uses for Illumina sequencing is to use multiomics to understand gene expression and regulation. By combining epigenetic and transcriptome analysis, researchers can better understand how cells respond to their environment. In this video, we'll explain how to combine these two approaches in a multiomics workflow.
Every cell in your body has the exact same genes. But what makes a skin cell different than a stomach cell, for example, is the way in which those genes are expressed. To fit in the nucleus, most of our DNA is condensed. So one of the determinants of gene expression is whether a given gene is in a region of open or closed DNA. If DNA is open, then the regulatory sequences and genes in that open DNA are more accessible to transcriptional machinery and are more likely to be expressed, whereas genes in closed regions of chromatin are less likely to be expressed. This is why ATAC-seq and RNA-seq are a perfect combo. ATAC-seq measures whether regions of DNA are open or closed, suggesting that what may be expressed and what likely isn't. Adding RNA-seq removes inference from ATAC data by directly measuring the functional consequence of that chromatin state. For even more resolution into complex samples, ATAC-seq and RNA-seq can be combined in single-cell experiments. The most widely used method to do single-cell ATAC-seq and RNA-seq is to prepare samples using the 10x Genomics Multiome Kit and sequence the resulting libraries on an Illumina sequencer. The first and most important step is getting good, high-quality nuclei from your tissue of interest. Start by breaking up the tissue and lysing the cells gently enough to have the nuclei remain intact. Then separate the nuclei from cellular debris via methods like column filtration or flow sorting. An accurate measure of the quantity of whole intact nuclei is critical. Using an automated hemocytometer or cell counter can help identify the proportion of nuclei in your sample that are high quality and completely dissociated rather than present in clumps. At this point in the workflow, nuclei can be stored at minus 70 degrees Celsius. The next step is to begin preparing each nucleus for sequencing via addition of barcodes. One of the most popular ways to do this is via a microfluidic approach provided by 10x Genomics. The 10x multiome approach uses an instrument to create an emulsion. Single cells, or nuclei, are isolated into droplets which contain a barcoded bead. The barcoded bead captures the nucleic acids of interest from each cell or nucleus and labels them uniquely so that we can later identify which transcriptomic and epigenomic data came from which cell. Luckily, all that single cell isolation and sequencing prep is as easy as pipetting up to 15,000 nuclei into the chromium chip. In less than 30 minutes, you are ready to take barcoded nucleotides from the chip, then conduct two separate library preps to make Illumina-compatible libraries, one for ATAC-seq and another for gene expression. At the end of the 10x library protocol, you'll have two indexed libraries that are ready for some final checks before we're ready to load onto the sequencer. We want to check the concentration and length of the final libraries. We'll perform qPCR to quantify our sample. We'll also run the final libraries on a bioanalyzer or similar instrument to determine if the length of the library matches what's expected in terms of size. By this point, we've completed ATAC and RNA-seq library preps and have checked concentrations and quality on our final libraries. Because the libraries have different sequencing recommendations, it is recommended to sequence them on separate flow cells. You can determine how many total cells that you can sequence by dividing the total number of reads that are possible on an Illumina flow cell by the number of reads required per cell. For this experiment, 10x recommends at least 20,000 reads per nucleus for gene expression and 25,000 reads per nucleus for ATAC-seq. This means that you can profile gene expression in 80,000 nuclei and perform ATAC-seq on 64,000 nuclei on two 1.5B NovaSeq X flow cells.